Hey everybody, I'm Scott Meek with Diesel Training. I hope you've been enjoying our tech tip videos that we've been putting out for you, but it dawned on me that not everybody's ready for advanced level oscilloscope diagnostics, right? Some technicians need a little bit of the fundamentals. So in this case, today I want to focus on a fundamental principle of electricity, and that fundamental we're going to talk about is going to be amperage draw. Now, what is amperage draw? Amperage is how we measure current flow. Current flow is the electrons moving through a circuit. We need to be able to measure that, so to make sense of that, we use a multimeter, maybe an amp clamp, and we measure that amperage draw in that circuit. A good example of when we'd measure amperage draw is actually right behind me. This 2012 ProStar actually has an HVAC problem with the blower motor. What's happening is, after about 5 minutes of operation, the breaker will actually trip. Now, what causes breakers to trip or fuses to blow? Well, there's essentially one cause of that, and that means there's too much current or amperage moving through that circuit. It's increased above the rated spec of that breaker or fuse. So today, I want to walk you through the troubleshooting steps on how to figure out, when my circuit breaker tripped and I had too much amperage draw, is it because of a failed component or do I actually have a short to ground? So come on in and we'll take a look. All right, so before we actually start taking our measurements, we need to make sure that our multimeter is prepared to take those measurements. So a couple of quick tests that we will do, we'll test the leads and the fuses inside your multimeter for the amperage settings. So to do that, we're gonna take the dial and move to the omega symbol or the resistance setting. The first test that we'll do is we'll take our positive and negative leads and we'll connect them together. This is going to verify that our leads do have a good contact and there's not an open in these leads. Now, once that's done, we're going to disconnect the positive and negative lead. I'm going to now take the positive lead and go to the 400 milliamp setting. Now, remember, that is less than one half of an amp. So I'll take the positive lead, install it into the 400 milliamp setting. Now, here you'll notice we have a resistance value of 7.1 ohms. That means that the fuse inside this meter for the 400 milliamp setting is working. We'll then take the positive lead and move to our other setting, which is the 20 amp max. When I install the lead, I now have 0 to 1/10 of an ohm resistance, which means that fuse is good as well. So now that we've tested our meter, leads, and fuses, now we can start to take our measurements. So like I mentioned previously, this circuit breaker will actually trip after about 5 minutes of operation. Now that generally doesn't indicate a short to ground, but there's always the potential that there is one or that it's intermittent. So before we move on, we want to check each side of that breaker for a short to ground. And to safely do so our meter gives us an accurate reading, we want to go ahead and disconnect our batteries first. So let's go ahead and get those batteries disconnected so we can make these first steps. We have our batteries disconnected, it's time to check for our short to ground on both sides of the circuit. To do that, all we need to do is remove the circuit breaker from the circuit, take our multimeter, set it on the omega symbol for resistance, then we're going to take our black lead and place it on a known good ground port. Once we have a known good ground, we're going to take our red lead and we're going to start by going to each side of the circuit breaker to check for that short to ground. So I'm going to start by going to the terminal furthest away from me, and our value is roughly 12.81 kOhm, which is 12,800 ohms. That does not indicate a short to ground. Now I'm going to move my test lead to the terminal closest to me of the removed circuit breaker. Here I have 196.1 kOhm, which is 196,000 ohms of resistance. This also does not indicate a short to ground. However, if you trace this circuit, you'll see that this side of the circuit goes to what they call a linear power module. So if I disconnect the linear power module and this resistance value goes away, then that proves the resistance we currently have is from that module and we do not have a short to ground. So let's unplug it and recheck. You'll notice now our value is out of limits, which means the resistance value we were reading was coming from our linear power module, which now indicates to us we do not have a short to ground on either side. Now we need to reassemble, reconnect the batteries, and measure our amperage draw to see if our blower motor is drawing too much current. All right, so now we're going to check the amperage draw. Now, something to be aware of, this particular circuit has a 30 amp breaker. What that means is there's a potential this circuit could draw up to 30 amps. Now, we have to set our multimeter to check the measurement value, but remember, this meter has a maximum of a 20 amp draw before the fuse inside the meter blows. So be cognizant of that when you're testing. I would always recommend to set up your meter and start the blower motor on the lowest speed. So we're going to take our red lead, move it to our 20 amp port, and then we're going to set the dial to the appropriate location, which is the 20 amp amperage measurement. Now, all we have to do is take our leads, put one lead on one side of the remove terminal, take the other lead and put it on the other side. Now we're prepared to take our amperage measurement. So I'm going to start on the lowest speed and see what our draw is. On our lowest speed, we're drawing roughly 5.8 amps of current. Now, that's not too much to blow the circuit breaker, so we're still good. So we'll continue to increase the speed. So we're currently at 12.8 or 13 amps. Now I am on my highest setting, which means I have the highest amperage draw. I am currently only drawing 13 amps of current. Being that this is a 30 amp breaker, this breaker should not be blowing with 30 amps of current. We've proven it's not shorted to ground because our resistance value is in the thousands, not in the hundreds or less than 100 in the single digits. So this proves that our failure is our circuit breaker. All right, so just a recap. We had a circuit breaker that was tripping. We wanted to verify that we did not have a short to ground on either wire to make sure that wasn't causing our breaker issue. So we disconnected the batteries. We checked each wire to ground, and we had thousands of ohms of resistance, which indicates an open circuit in our world. Now, if we were less than 100 ohms on either one of those wires, then I would have suspected a short to ground. But in this particular case, there was no short to ground, but we still had a breaker that was tripping. So we moved on to our amperage measurement, where we measured the maximum amperage draw of that blower motor on high speed, which was a maximum of 12 amps. So if we have a 12 amp draw and a 30 amp breaker that's tripping, that indicates to us we have a failed resettable breaker. Once we replaced the breaker, our blower motor went to functioning properly. One last thing I want to discuss is, in the chance that we were starting to get close to 20 amps using our multimeter, there's a chance we could blow that fuse if we exceeded a 20 amp draw. In that case, we would want to use something called an amperage clamp. Now, I'm going to teach you how to use this amperage clamp in an upcoming tech tip video. So I'd love for you to join us at training.diesellaptops.com and click our tech tip link to view the video from there. Thank you guys for joining us today. We hope you learned a few lessons, and we'll see you soon.